Hey, I am Jelle, and after making 2D games, 3D games, and even a 4D game, it is time to take my quest even further. I am going to make a 1D game? Hey, is this correct?
Yes. Go on. You're doing great.
What do you mean? Is this for real? Whose idea was this? Hey, we aren't done here. Hey, we are on. Alright. How would a 1D game even work? I saw this cool video online where they made a 1D game in the form of a first-person 2D game. When we look in front of us, we basically see a 3D world projected on the backs of our eyes as a 2D plane. Now, what if we take this down one dimension? According to my personal Bible, Flatlanders, where you have to think like a 2D creature, instead of being able to see up, down, left and right, all you can see is a line, because everything is flat. You could then make out different shapes based on the distance and color to each object, kind of how we see shapes and colors. Now, how could we achieve this in a game? Top-down mode activates. Right now, everything you see can be seen as a top-down 2D game. Just imagine that everything is completely flat. If I then shoot a bunch of laser rays around me, kind of like my fractal video, and check what I hit and how far it is, I can create a boundary around me of distances and colors. Now all I have to do is translate the shape into a horizontal line and ta-da! I have 1D vision. It might look a little bit weird at the beginning, but if I stretch it out a bit, it looks a lot more intuitive. It kind of becomes a maze you have to go through. Alright, let's put this theory into a game. You know, this 2D monitor is just too distracting for me. I need a simpler one, so I can transport myself into a one-dimensional frame of mind. I only know one kind of 1D screen, and you see it all the time, especially during the holidays. Yeah, I'm talking about an LED strip. I saw this awesome game called Line Wobbler, where the game was controlled with an LED strip. This was perfect for my 1D game. Alright, so while I was waiting for my strip to arrive, I got started on the actual game. But what is it even going to be about? Well, let me explain. Alright, it is going to be a racing game, and you have to finish first. Yeah, that's about it. Let's get to work! The first thing I made was a track. I created a tile palette to quickly draw a racetrack shape, and since all you're going to see is one row of colored LEDs, well, I don't really have to spend that much time on the visuals, do I? I made a super simple racing controller. Just press forward to go forward, press left or right to go left. Alright, who would have figured? I created some checkpoints, and when you go through all of them in the correct order, you complete a lap. Complete enough laps to finish the race. To test out if the game would even work on an LED strip, I made a virtual one with these 3D light bulbs I made. I made a script that would spawn the lights according to how many rays I wanted to use, and also what field of view I wanted to use. Like a field of view of 90 degrees, or even 180 degrees. Why don't I just go all around me? And you know what would be extra fun? Now that I can turn all the way around, why don't I make the rays static? So each LED always points in the same direction, regardless of where I'm currently looking. This would mean I would have to rotate when looking around to race, just like the real deal. Now, we still have a big problem. It's totally unclear what you're looking at. When something is close enough, you see a red color. And if there's nothing, the LED turns off. This red and black distinction is totally insufficient to have any chance of actually winning a race. Luckily, LEDs have a color. And colors have different properties we can change to change that color. You see where I'm going? Huh? Huh? You might have known this already, but RGB LEDs are actually three LEDs combined. A red, green and blue one, RGB. The easiest way to control an LED like that is to control the red, green and blue parts separately. And then this combines into a single color if you're far enough away. Now, controlling the color by its RGB values isn't very intuitive, especially if you're trying to have some sort of logical color code to better understand what's going on. Everyone, welcome our savior, HSV. Or hue, saturation, value. This method is far more intuitive and probably the way you pick a color. The hue is the tint of the color, basically what part of the rainbow you want. The saturation is the amount of color, ranging from gray all the way to pure red, for example. The value is how bright your color is, ranging from black to full white. These parameters can be useful for understanding a line. In this game, I chose to use the hue to show the kind of object you're looking at. The walls are red and the finish line is yellow. I use the value, or brightness, to show the distance the hit point is to you. If an LED is black, that means the point is too far away to worry about. If it's very bright, that means it's right in your face. Lastly, I used saturation to show what direction the obstacle is facing compared to you. I compare the normal of the surface to your forward direction, and the more they are facing each other, the more saturated the color gets. Basically, if the wall becomes bright red, you're going straight at it. So don't do that. Practically, I cast a race all around the player, and since it's a 2D game, and the Z-axis doesn't do anything right now, I use the Z-axis of the scale to set the hue of the object. That way, I don't have to bother with getting sprites, color and such. As I was testing the game, I noticed a big problem. I had no idea where I was looking. You could kind of tell by the way the environment was moving when you were moving. But when you're in the middle of a hectic race and you're constantly moving around, I doubt you're going to get very far. So I added a small green dot in front of the player that would always face your forward direction. Much better. Let's do some testing. All that racing was pretty fun, but I needed some opponents. I stole the NPC controllers from my back in game and gave them a blue color. Their main and only goal is to get to the next checkpoint. Look at them go, they have zero mercy. Now of course, with the added NPCs, I need to think of a way to show how good you're doing. Are they ahead or are they behind? Once they're out of your field of view, you will have no idea. Let's make the number of direction LEDs in front of you the number of your current place. The smaller the number, the better you're doing. There was one more thing that kept bothering me. You know, in normal racing games, you can see arrows all around the track to see where you need to go. But drawing an arrow on a line is kind of difficult. Of course, I still got some tricks up my sleeve. Have you guys ever heard of water and the waves they produce? It looks like the water is moving forward with the wave. However, in reality, the particles are just moving up and down, one after another, to give the illusion of the wave going forward. I can do the same thing with the LEDs, by varying their brightness based on a sine wave in the direction of the next checkpoint. That way, you always know where to go. All clear. The game is coming together quite the... Aha! Perfect timing. Look what came into the mail. My LED strip. I got straight to testing the strip, but for some reason, nothing seemed to be working. Then I realized there is an information flow. So I connected the LED strip from the other side, and now we have light. When I got through that first hurdle, I had some more problems trying to display the LEDs fast enough. Sending the LED information through an USB cable is actually pretty slow. I can crank up the read rate, but that still only gave me a couple of frames per second. I had to do some optimizing. Instead of sending the hex code of every LED as text to the Arduino, I figured that was actually very inefficient, because I don't need to know what the color is, only the Arduino does. There is no need to send it as human readable code, instead I can just send the bytes directly. 3 per LED, red, green and blue. 3 bytes per LED for 300 LEDs is just 900 bytes. Very manageable. Alright, now I just need to strap the LEDs to this giant hula hoop. Hula hoop! Alright, let's go! You know, instead of using this boring old PlayStation controller while rotating around the strip, why don't I make this tool itself the controller? Time to make a special controller! Yalla style! I present to you the Stool Controller 9000. If you take a look at the underside of the Stool Controller, you might see my patented Super Advanced Human Stabilization System, or S. It allows anything to enjoy this tool without worrying about falling off while using one of its key features, spinning really fast. When it came to actually designing the electronics, well, that's a whole different story. Measuring the rotation of an object is pretty easy most of the time. You can use a potentiometer, like how I made the steering wheel last year, or you can use a rotary encoder to calculate your current rotation speed. There is a big problem with these methods though. I need a way to detect my absolute rotation because the LED strip is stationary, and I need to be able to rotate continuously because the track is a loop. I was looking around my sensor collection and found the perfect thing, an ambient light sensor, or phototransistor. It measures the amount of light that is hitting it at any given point and puts out a value from 0 to 1023. Now, and here comes the best part, light doesn't necessarily mean a shining light. It could also use black and white paper, for example, or even a gradient. Yes. Wrapping the gradient around my turntable and using this handy 3D printed part I made to house the light sensor and an LED to shine means I can measure the exact rotation of the stool at any point. Just give it the big swing at the start to calibrate, and off you go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, get ready for a demonstration of epic proportions. A 1D racing game on an LED strip controlled with this tool. Let's go.
All right, time for the calibration.
3, 2, 1, 0.
Go. Push it more correctly. Let's go forward. A little bit more. Yes, yes. Let's get them. Oh, there's a lot of corners here. Why did I make so many corners? Let's go. All right. There it is. All right. I think I'm doing good. I don't know. We're going in the right direction. That's good. I'm doing good. More cornering. Should be near the end, right? Where are my enemies? I need to get them. They're probably way ahead of me. But I'm not giving up yet. Let's go. All these corners. Keep turning. That's where I need to go. Let's go, yeah. Doing good. All these corners. Where is the finish line? There it is! Oh my god, I made it. Unbelievable. I might be dead last, but I sure as hell hit one.
That was pretty fun. Maybe a little dizzying, but nothing a good old bucket can solve. And I put the source files on GitHub for anyone who wants to make something similar. Thank you very much for watching all the way to the end. If you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos in the future. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!